Spicy Girl and Double Keziah. Welcome to the show. So I want to come on here really quickly and speak on a couple of topics, okay, a couple of celebrities, okay? So let's run it down. We're going to speak about Master P and his son Romeo first. He ain't little Romeo no more. He big Romeo now, okay, with a family of his own. He said he has his own family. Wow, time has fly. So they're beefing. Father and son is feuding. Mind you, they both just lost one, Romeo, his sister, two, Master P's daughter, Tatiana Miller, okay? She was so young and she died due to overdose, all right? And you would think that they would still be in this grieving moments and, you know, still holding each other up in this mournful time because she just recently passed away. But no, they feuding over some money, okay? And Romeo wants his money. He wants his cut because he says that he's been promoting this company called Rap Snacks. So this is new to me. I had to look into this. And it is a hip-hop inspired snacks for rappers. So you would get a bag of chips and you would have their names and their pictures and then titles that matches the celebrity. Like Nicki Minaj, she has Barbecue. Like barbecue? Yeah, so... wow. So yeah, so I'm just like, what the heck? So he's saying that how the father told him that he had to wait a very long time to get his money, get his cut. And then come to find out that was all a lie. And he felt like he put in a lot of work. He's been very loyal. And he felt like his father just was not being a professional businessman slash father when it comes down to his financial situation, okay? I don't understand. People have a ton of money. I don't get that. But I wouldn't get why would the father want to hold the money off from his son. So again, we don't know if maybe his son wasn't financially responsible. We don't know if he would have took the money and just spent it and splurging on things. We don't know. Sometimes parents do certain things for their child's best interest. You just never know until very later on. Okay. But the fact is that he should be getting paid and he should be getting the money. What stuck out to me was that explosion of a tweet when Romeo was talking about you wasn't even there for your children. Emotionally, what are you doing commenting on Stefan Twitch boss, his passing, giving your condolences and writing a letter to him when you wasn't even there for your own children? And I was just like, is he freaking serious? And I quote, I've seen a man avoid his own children's struggle with suicide and depression, but post another man who passed away today that he doesn't even know. Y'all idols be lost. Better stop following the blind. Watch when it's revealed. That is crazy. That is crazy. And then Master P responded. He said, son, I love you. Stop trying to get people to feel sorry for you. And let's come up with a solution. He added, you can come talk to your father and the family like a man. You have kids too. No family's perfect. But together with God, we can heal and get through this. Okay? That is what Master P was saying. But at the very end of the day, he threw me for a loop when he said that about, oh, y'all idols really be blind. Then Romeo also mentioned this. He says that Tatiana Miller changed his whole view of their relationship. None of y'all love my father more than me. I know my sister's passing was a warning. And just like Moses in the Bible, the man that leads the people out isn't always allowed to the promised land because of his own ego. He continued, don't have to be perfect, but I can't follow someone who's been blinded. Wow. So again, he's definitely giving it to us about his father. But all I can say is I really hope that father and son can work this situation out. Like, social media is really taking things up a notch. People just spew their whole relationship, their whole issues out on social media. And what you're supposed to do is take it to that person. Stop bringing it to social media. That's not how you conduct things. That's not how you do things. That's not how you work things out, because you actually make the situation worse, because then you bring other nosy heads, you know, other busybodies all up in your business. And then you're going to get people talking and talking and even just start spreading things. Sometimes you cannot trust family. They'll be quick to betray you than a doggone stranger in the street. And it's facts. I mean, I think that many people could attest to that. And it's really a sad situation. It's really something that a lot of us could be, you know, could give a testimony. I'm sure you probably watching got a testimony of a family member doing you dirty, you know, and that's not acceptable. That is not acceptable. That's not what family is about. Family is not about shading and getting over on one another. So I don't know if that was what Master P intentions was, to get over his son and pocket all that money for himself and just gain all the profit, and his son reaps none of the benefits. But that's not okay. If your son was part of the brand and part of the promotion, then yes, give your son some of that money. But it should never have to be taken to the internet, because again, that's very personal, and you should never bring your family affairs online. To bring awareness, yes, you will want to tell people about what's going on, about this and that, but certain things I do believe and feel you need to keep offline, period. There's no ifs, ands, or but about it. You feel me? Like, you got to talk about Miss Lizzo and Ashley Graham. So Ashley Graham is a plus size model, and she's not a black woman, clearly. And that is the point I'm gonna bring home here to y'all. So bear with me. Yeah, so here's a journalist. Her name is Sameera Khan. So she's a journalist, and she quoted this on Twitter. So the fat positivity movement is getting out of hand, because there's a picture of Ashley Graham stepping out of a hotel, looks like, stepping out, child, in a mini lingerie type dress and with some super high heels. I'm like, girl, where the heck are you going? Where's your husband? Anyway, yeah, so this is what Ms. Khan wrote. And Twitter dragged her by her edges. I could understand, you know, people don't like the body shaming and so on and so forth like that. But we do have to be aware that there is a very high alarming rate of people that are obese and overweight. And I cannot glorify that. You're going to have little children thinking that it's okay to grow up and to be big and to be overweight, and that's not cool. It's something called BMI, and we should all strive to be within our BMI, period. We should not be striving to have excess fat and body weight on us. I'm sorry, it is what it is. But Ashley Graham is overall an attractive woman. Lizzo is also a nice looking woman too as well. And you know, and I'm sure many could agree to that. But at the very end of the day, listen, you don't got to be a size 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You don't. You don't have to be a 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but your behind can at least, you know what I'm saying, make sure you're healthy. You can be thick. Listen here, we're not supposed to all look alike and be the same size and be the same weight and have the same body and have everything popping off the same. No. I think the world will be very boring if we all look the same, no matter how gorgeous a woman is. I mean, I wouldn't want to look like everyone else, and I wouldn't want anyone to look like me, period. But at the very end of the day, we cannot promote something that is unhealthy. No, doggone good at will, walking around 400 pounds ain't healthy. You know it ain't right. If you really love somebody, you want to see them look their best. You want to see them feel their best. That's the bottom line. That's true love. Not just, oh, accept me for who I am. If you're unhealthy and sickly, then at the end of the day, I mean, what are we doing here? And I get that Lizzo can dance and she can move and she can play her flute. Talented woman. But if she has any type of health issues, then yes, I would definitely advise Lizzo to definitely lose the weight, and Ashley Graham too. So a lot of people came to Ashley Graham's defense over this woman and called her the B word, said she was jealous, that maybe her man was checking out Ashley Graham's Instagram and she's hating because being thin and skinny ain't it. That ain't the go ticket no more. Being thick and voluptuous, that's what's in, that's what's popping. I don't know. At the end of the day, attractive woman is an attractive woman despite her size. I don't think slim and skinny is going anywhere out of style, but you know, thick women, you know what I'm saying, they getting up there too, as far as like being adored and admired and so, because every man don't like the same size, you know, every man don't like a skinny woman or a thin woman, and every man don't like a thick woman or overweight woman. It's too much men on the doggone earth for them to all like the same damn thing. Everybody was like, okay, we're gonna come defend Ashley because this chick is bugging. But then Twitter turned around and whoa, what happened to Lizzo? Where's the love for Lizzo? Why y'all not coming for Lizzo the same way how you come for Ashley Graham? Mm-hmm. What's up with that? What is going on with that? Some people definitely left their tweets, definitely gave their thoughts and opinions on that, and they held no punches back, okay? And I do feel like because Lizzo is a black woman, black women versus non-black women, white women, mixed women, Hispanic women, they could be big, overweight, Asian women, Indian women, and they would not get the same backlash as a black woman. And that's just the bottom line. Lizzo has always been trash for her weight, for how she dressed. And at the very end of the day, you know, if Lizzo can't do it, neither no one else should. If Lizzo can't be big and overweight and wear whatever she want to wear, then the other women shouldn't be big and overweight and wear whatever the heck they want to wear too, and call it bold and making a statement. Bold my ass. You know, y'all don't say the same thing for Lizzo. And yes, I do agree with, you know, dressing in modest apparel and covering that ass up, covering them breasts up, covering yourself up, period. Because she did call Ashley Graham in that outfit a fat whore. Now, I thought that was a bit much. You know, I'm all for covering yourself and leaving things to the imagination. I understand that Ashley Graham is a mother. She has children. And some women want to feel good after they have a child. Some women want to step out in their best after they have a child. They want the world to be like, look at me, I had a child and I still got it. But at the very end of the day, I wouldn't have made that statement. I just know that black men and black women, we can't do what other people do. I have a ministry that I follow and he always says this to us. He said, listen here, sisters and brothers, you guys can't do what the other nations do. So if you're a black woman or a black man, you cannot go around cussing out police officers, picking up rocks, throwing it at them and thinking that they're going to let you slide. They're going to pop you one time before you even get the rock in your hand. Okay? White women could throw rocks at police officers and do certain things to them and she won't get tased. You go ahead and just dig in your pocket, you know, and then it's like, oh, he got a gun. But then you just trying to get your asthma pump because you scared and now your asthma all triggered. You're breathing heavily. You don't know what to do. You're all frantic because you got cops pointing guns at you and then you get shot 20 times. All because you wanted to get your asthma pump and you wasn't causing no harm. Or you got your hands up and you complying and you still get shot by the police. You see? But white folks can go toe-to-toe, you know what I'm saying? Tussle, could dance in the police office all day long in the mud, and ain't nothing happened. So they not a hair on their head is touched or plucked. Okay? So we can't do what they do. See, a white woman could walk around, you know what I'm saying, could walk up in the hood and chew, and may turn their head or two. But a black woman, oh, that fat slob. That's just the reality of it. That's just the reality. Black women can't do what other women do. You know what I'm saying? It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Women are criticized overall in general, but I know it's harder and it's worse for black women. It just is what it is. You know what I'm saying? So I do believe it is a racial thing too behind that. Why would they not defend Lizzo with her weight versus how they did with Ashley Graham? So y'all can leave a comment. Y'all can tell me how y'all feel about that.